previously on Harrow.
Our divers found a skull in the river. The Turbot Street's confirmed it's Robert Quinn. He was murdered.
Do me a favour. Don't mention this to Harrow.
You have to check in on Mum.
Doctor.
My ex-wife is in there. Sir, I want to see her.
You're going to have to give me something.
Why are you going to arrest me for murder?
The cops raided Steph's house on your recommendation.
What did you tell them?
I do remember Quinn and his blue Commodore.
That you fitted two ties to. Why?
Someone hacked into the sidewall with a screwdriver.
Fan error.
No, that's Jack Twine. Told me everything I know. That rules are there to be skirted around.
So he knows all your deepest, darkest secrets.
Every single one of them.
Stradas Maria, Miloship Puna, Anstebo, Hujina Nas, Shimasi Senami, Apoishnani. Lord Sivotatve, O Jesus. Svata Maria, Matko Boji, Rosana Vishne, Nini Vodinu Shmerti Nasi. Amen.
Come in.
Jack, hi.
Das.
Soraya.
Join me for a nightcap. What day is it?
Sunday.
Absent friends. He doesn't know you're here, does he?
No.
You like him, don't you? I do too. Never had a boy or a girl. Pam and I tried, but she couldn't. And I wanted one so much. So I was left with a choice. Leave her, remarry, make a mark, leave a legacy, or stay.
And you stayed.
I loved her. Despite that shortcoming that some may have seen as a fatal flaw, I chose her.
And you still left a legacy.
What fatal flaw are you looking for?
Would Daniel ever break the law?
Oh, come on now. We'd all break the law for the right reasons. Why?
His ex-wife, Steph, her husband was murdered.
That Quinn bloke.
You knew him?
I know he fleeced Dan's ex for $500,000. When did he die?
October 3rd, last year.
And you're here to ask me what? Could Daniel have been involved?
He is secretive, and you know his secrets. If he did something wrong, I need to know.
No wonder he likes you.
It's nice to meet you, Jack.
They found it.
I woke up early this morning wondering why Fairly and Pavitch were being so hush-hush.
Now we know.
Why didn't they tell us?
It was me they didn't want to tell.
Why not? What did they think you were going to do?
I don't know. I'm not sure I should be your boss. They don't trust me, and you need to learn from someone you can trust. Hello, Jack. You okay?
Nah, mate, I'm dead. I've decided to haunt you through the mobile network. Are you busy?
This is security footage taken from outside the Bowen Hills Racing Club September 27th last year. And as you can see, it shows Quinn's car. Both right side tires slashed. So, we want to talk to Fern Harrow. Now, here's some places you can start. This is her mother's house, and that's her father's boat. But she's very comfy laying low.
Does her mother know that Quinn's remains have been ID'd?
No, not yet.
What's the charge?
Well, we just want to talk to her. But we are compiling a brief of evidence for a charge of murder.
And are you thinking that a girl her size put a man like Quinn into the river alone?
Well, at this stage, Phil, we don't know, but I think we all have to assume that she had some help. Her boyfriend, Callum Proud. We all clear?
Sergeant Dass.
Hi, Soraya. It's Simon. Van Rijk?
Hi, Simon. Van Rijk. What's up?
Can we catch up?
I've given him a call.
Hey, Joe.
Dan, hi. Do you need me?
No, I'm just off to see Jack.
You mind? They're trying to do a job here. They don't need spectators.
It's okay, Jared. He's a friend of Jack Twine's.
Jesus.
Shush, your big deal. They still out there?
Who?
The grave diggers taking Stan Wagner away.
Yeah. Is that what you called me?
What did you see?
That he was Catholic and dead.
And?
And there was some award fallen on the floor.
Yeah. What did Wagner die of, do you know?
Around here, excitement.
That old bastard was as fit as a pole dancer. And he had God on his side.
And he looked about 110.
96.
That's not a bad innings.
That's not a good reason. Have you learned anything in the last 30 years?
What are you thinking?
Well, I'm thinking that it's worth thinking about. Hmm. Look at that. 10% body fat. Lucky bastard.
Anyway.
Oh. Petrichial hemorrhaging. Check his eyes.
There's some more here. But there could be any number of reasons why.
Check his throat. Didn't I teach you anything?
Phone.
Asphyxiation.
Hey! What the hell are you two doing?
Oh, we're just saying goodbye to Stan.
Ah, bullshit. You didn't even like the foreign prick. You were a nosy old bastard, Twine.
Hey.
Do you want me to get Joe? No, she's right there. She'd love to see how you guys are interfering with the body of a dead resident. No? Take off.
Charming fellow.
Interesting reaction, though.
Not enamored of the elderly.
Not enamored of foreigners.
Fran Harrow is a person of interest in the murder of Robert Quinn. I want to check if Harrow was working here on October the 3rd last year, which is the date Robert Quinn made his last phone call and his car went into the den. What?
This is ridiculous. You've known Harrow longer than I have. How can you entertain such a thought?
Everyone has two sides, Max.
What, even Fern?
Well, it's Occam's razor. You know, the principle where the hypothesis with the fewest assumptions
is... Don't you dare explain Occam's law of parsimony to me.
Listen, okay, so Harrow carted in at 9:32 a.m. on the 3rd and carted out at 3:19 a.m. on the 4th. Well, I guess he's in the clear then. Hey, listen, have you given any more thought to my proposal?
Pick your moments, Brian.
Yeah, okay.
But remember, this young doctor's a real stick in the mud, so hammer him.
Okay.
Knock, knock. Jack, I'll get around to you shortly.
Ah, sorry to interrupt you, Doctor. Just my young friend here can't help himself. He's got a couple of questions. I couldn't stop him.
Daniel Harrow, pathologist.
Uh-huh.
I wanted to ask about Stan Wagner.
There's no need for you to see Mr. Wagner. He's going straight to the School of Anatomy.
He bequeathed his body.
I have 23 more residents to see this morning, Mr. Harrow.
Dr. Harrow. How did Mr. Wagner die?
Congestive heart failure.
And what caused the heart failure? Myocarditis, previous infarctions, thyroid disease?
His blood pressure was low, his cholesterol was high, and he was old. It was my determination that he died of heart failure. His son was also okay with that determination.
He had significant hemorrhaging in his face, eyes, mouth.
You've seen the body.
Sorry, Doctor, I couldn't stop him.
Do I need to call Turbot Street and ask why you're interrogating me, Dr. Harrow? Heart failure.
One last question. Where did he die? I saw the frame on the floor. Was he on his way to the toilet?
He was in bed when I was asked to inspect his deceased remains. Maybe he knocked it off on the way back. There is no need for an autopsy.
Thank you so much for backing me up in there.
Well, he's my doctor. I can't piss him off.
Oh, but I can.
Heart attack, my hairy white one. Wagner was active. He ate like a starved dog. There was no fluid retention, no visceral congestion that I ever heard.
So what do you want me to do? Break into the School of Anatomy and examine his body?
Why so secret, Squirrel?
I don't know. I feel like secrecy is the fashion of the day around here. They found Quinn's skull. Did you know?
Yeah.
And were you also part of the Don't Tell Harrow conspiracy? Why? What did you think he was going to do?
It wasn't my call.
Yeah, but what do you think?
I don't know.
You think he was involved? No. No
Simon.
Way.
Simon. Max
Maxine wants you.
No way.
Ah, you're the spreadsheet nerd. What does this mean?
That's the staff entry logs.
Yeah, yeah, but what are these? These asterisks, they're only there on this day. Has someone fiddled with it?
October 3rd. I don't know. Maybe just computer error. Huh. Nothing.
Okay. Thank you.
Actually, I don't have a death certificate yet. That's why I'm ringing, because I need to know what will happen if he is declared dead. I think the police think that he was killed. Homicide. Homicide? Uh-huh. Yeah, I need to call you back. Thanks. Hi.
Is that what the cops think? That Robert was murdered?
I don't know.
You seem pretty sure.
Well, I'm not.
I want to know.
I don't know anything.
Why did the cops search our house?
Are you hungry?
It was to do with Robert, wasn't it? Were they going to arrest you?
Please.
You're not telling me everything.
Well, I don't know anything else.
So why the life insurance call?
Honey, I have to... What do you want to know all of this
I want to know about Robert.
Why?
Because he hit you. And I know you went to hospital.
I was okay.
I don't trust that he won't hurt you again. I need to know if Robert's dead or not.
Can you just wait, please?
Yeah.
Brian.
Hi, Steph. Mind if we come in?
I'd rather you didn't.
Well, search warrant's still valid, so. Just want to ask you a couple more little things.
Why, don't you think you were thorough enough last time? So what is it that you want to know now?
Where's Fern?
Why?
We'd like to talk to her.
So would I.
Where is she now?
Northern New South Wales. She went there with her boyfriend.
That's Callum Proud.
Yep.
When?
A week or so. Why, Brian?
How long has Fern known Mr. Proud for?
I don't know. I only met him recently. There's nothing in there.
Uh-huh. How recently?
Hi. I'm about to do something slightly illegal.
Wanna join?
Hey, Griff. Perfect day, Doc. No one here but me doing the prep. You doing any more guest lecturing next year?
That's the plan, unless something goes wrong. Are you ready for your end of terms?
Peripheral neuropathy? I thought getting laid was hard.
Read Strupland, 4th edition. I'll text you a link.
Thanks, Doc.
Here, keep it. I've got a spare.
Thanks, Griff.
You just trust him? It's Harrow. If you can't trust him, then what's the point?
What are we looking for?
Well, the attending doctor said natural causes. Jack thinks otherwise.
Does Jack have any proof?
Nope.
So there's no crime reported, no crime scene, no chain of evidence with this body, no formal permission to even be here.
I'm technically on staff here. Wagner was sent here.
Look, I'm trying to help him. Do you want to help me or not?
Right. What are your first impressions?
Good skin color. Liver function probably okay.
He shattered his wrist. Probably quite young. It's badly set.
There's a mark on this wrist here. Could be from a tight watch band.
Yes.
Here.
Significant scarring. Burn or acid? Very old. What do you make of his face?
Mild cyanosis of the lips. Some broken blood vessels on the cheek here. Petechial hemorrhaging. Anoxia.
That's what we think too.
A man of his age could be 100 causes.
Jack was right. There's no fluid retention. His renal system is fine. He's pretty healthy and there's no clear bruises on his body that I can see. Right, let's have a look. There's some lung froth back there. Not that much.
It's a bit more hemorrhaging.
A coughing fit could have caused that. Hello. That looks like a feather.
You mean like a feather from a pillow? You think he was smothered?
Possibly. Get these bloods tested. No need to tell anyone else.
Booyah. Hey, babe, I don't know what you're selling, but,
Daniel Harrow.
Oh, that prick.
Is my father.
Oh, did he find you?
Any call records for this number from October last year. I'm trying to find a missing person.
And how will you be paying?
Cash.
Well, that's gonna cost about...
$150 now, another $250 when you deliver. I'll find you.
Electrical burns to the skin of the thumb, forefinger and middle finger on the right hand.
Hi.
Oh, come in. I'm not supposed to let you in unless you're involved in the case. But, mum's the word, though. Shh, of course. Arrow's not the only rebel around here. I hope you're okay if I continue my work. Someone here has to.
Yeah, gosh. Sorry. Where is Harrow?
Oh, off tilting at who knows what windmill instead of being here during office hours.
I know. He bends the rules.
It's like saying James Blunt has the occasional good tune.
Does he ever bend them too far?
What do you mean?
Could he hurt someone?
Harrow is capable of stupid things, but hurting someone, I can't see it.
No cops?
My girlfriends.
Soraya.
20 cops went through everything. My toiletry bags, my bins, my wardrobe.
Soraya was just trying to find the truth.
Well, it's not in my underwear drawer. What do you want, Daniel?
Cops found a skull. In the river.
Is it? Was it you? Who did the check?
No. They're keeping me in the dark.
So why are they keeping me in the dark? Robert was my husband.
But why don't I just come in for a minute?
No.
I'll talk to Nichols.
No, he was right. It's not your business. I need to be by myself.
So, Kellen,
How long have you known Burn Hair April?
Why do you want to know?
Do you recognize this man?
No. But I recognize the house. It's Fern's mum's. Is that Fern's stepfather?
When did you first meet Fern?
What's this got to do with her stepfather? Does Fern know I'm here?
Well, I tell you what, why don't you just unlock your phone? Give her a call.
Yes?
Daniel Harrow, a friend of Jack Twine's down the hall.
Michael Wagner.
Sorry about your father.
Did you know Dad?
I rarely made it past Jack's room. Was your father happy here?
I think Dad liked it everywhere after what he went through as a young man.
During the war.
Was he in Czechoslovakia? So he told me, 1,000 times.
Do you have any friends here?
And not long ago, I heard there was another resident arrived, also from Eastern Europe. I thought Dad and her would have a lot to talk about, but no.
Do you know if there was anyone that might have wanted to harm your father?
Have you seen all his awards for community service?
Money?
He gave it all away. I paid for all this.
Hate?
Why are you asking this? You a cop?
I'm a pathologist.
Dad's dead. Let him go.
Who is the other resident, the other Eastern European?
Oh, a spider, Colonel! A spider!
If you get a complaint, complain in English, you miserable old Jew.
I don't think she wants your help.
I don't think that's your business.
I'm getting Joe.
No, you're not. You're Twine's little mate.
Dr. Twine to you.
Yeah, it's funny. I found an oxycodone wrapper in Twine's room. I checked his charts and he's not on oxy. Where do you get that from, I wonder? Come on, eh? You're English. You understand these people bring nothing to our country.
I'm Welsh, actually.
Oh, whatever you are. You're not going to tell anyone about this. Unless you want to get banned from visiting your little mate. You have a nice day.
It's okay. Mrs. Adams, isn't it? It's okay. Everything's gonna be okay.
Seriously, I've enjoyed all of this, but you either let me go or you let me phone a lawyer.
Okay. In a sec. First this. There's your phone. There's a search warrant for your phone.
What do you want?
I want to talk to Fern Harrow.
Why? She hasn't done anything wrong.
Well, there's nothing to worry about, is there? I want you to give her a call and ask her to meet you.
Rat her out. Fuck off, man.
Well, if you don't, Callan, we'll find the number in the phone, we will track her down, and we will arrest her. Now, we don't want that, do we? Because we both know she'll put up a bit of a fight. So, be smart, young fella.
The cops are looking for you. Can I phone that lawyer now?
You want a phone book?
Carla?
The cops are going to arrest Fern.
Something about a guy named Quinn.
Jesus!
That's two for two,
you
now.
You little shit.
Daniel Harrow, I'm here to see Senior Sergeant Brian Nichols.
Concerning?
The current investigation.
Sarge?
What?
He's not in his office. I'll try another number.
So, Fern Harrow can't drive. Callum Prayer could have driven Quinn's car into the dam.
Here's the problem.
What?
Callum Prayer was arrested on the morning of October the 3rd for possession. He was released on a surety on the 4th. Fern Harrow seen here on the 3rd getting cash sorted, and on the 4th filling out bail forms. All the time Quinn's car's travelling to the dam. Task Force Helikey. Sorry, Sergeant Nichols just stepped out.
I'll try his mobile.
Get rid of him. Nichols.
Sir, there's somebody down here at the front desk to see you. Mr. Daniel Harrow.
Well, what the bloody hell does he want?
I'll just ask. Excuse me, Mr.
And then I told them that Fern was coming in with my bail money. 10 minutes later, I was walking out.
Are they still looking for Fern?
What is this about? Who is Robert Quinn?
Fern's stepfather. He's dead. He was killed. On that day in October. Cops don't know who did it.
Has this got anything to do with why she's so messed up?
Messed up? Messed up how?
She's always looking over her shoulder. She jumps at nothing. She's scared all the time. Did you hurt her?
You really care about her? I hurt her. By not being there for her.
I want $50 on Kulu Queen. Yeah. Both to win, brother. Shit. Hang on.
You got it?
You got it? Yeah, I'm back.
What's this number? The last one he answered.
I'm not Wikipedia, baby. That's a public telephone box.
Do you know where it is?
I can find out.
You're here late.
I got the bloods back from your unofficial patient at the School of Anatomy.
What did you learn?
Not much. Blood type AB, no toxins. Racist assholes, huh?
Freedom of speech.
You think he killed Wagner?
I don't know.
What, because he was a foreigner? A hate crime?
I did see him being aggressive with another resident, a Hungarian woman. A Holocaust survivor, actually.
Really? How do you know?
She had a number tattooed here.
She was at a concentration camp?
She was at Auschwitz. That was the only Nazi camp that tattooed prisoners. Those they didn't send straight to the gas chambers.
And now this guy's abusing her. What a shithead. I guess the tattoos did kind of point the way. Anyway, sorry the bloods didn't help.
Bloods.
What? What is it?
Blood type and tattoos. He had a scar, remember? Wagner had a scar, right here.
Yeah, it was an old burn.
Exactly. He burned off a tattoo.
So, Fern Harrow is no longer a person of interest?
No. So it's back to the crease. Robert Quinn, eh? Made a lot of enemies, more than I'll ever know. It's very late.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
And Geneva?
No.
Well, yes. No, Max, no.
Yes.
All right.
Jack?
Jack!
Jesus
Christ, sorry.
I'm still here. And you still care?
Of course I do.
Hop into bed.
Oh, look, you're sweet, but I'm afraid I don't like loose men.
Okay.
Afraid I didn't bring any oxys with me.
Oh, that's okay. Okay. Oh. What have you learned?
Well, that you're still the best pathologist I have ever met.
Crawler. Why?
You were right. Wagner was murdered.
That young redneck, Rollins. Two of us. Good, that was one.
Working together again? The best.
Good student.
Hi, Mrs. Adams. But Adams wasn't your birth name. Did you marry into that name? Or did you change it when you came here?
A sodi. Adams was easier.
You were there. Auschwitz. And he was there too. Stan Wagner. But that wasn't his name either, was it? He had a tattoo as well. Only his was up here.
I read that some cut them out with knives. Some put a bullet through the arm to disguise it. It looks like Wagner burned his off with acid. The tattoo of his blood type. His Nazi SS tattoo.
I'm cold. I didn't think I would ever feel cold again. The train was cold. 3 days, no heat. Except for the bodies crammed around you. But they cooled when they died. Not even room for them to fall. My little sister and I were together on that trip, surrounded by frozen dead. Then the train stopped, the doors opened, the noise, the dogs, the smell of smoke. And he was there at the gate, at a desk by the rail tracks, in his beautiful, horrible SS uniform, with his handsome face and his broken wrist, deciding who went that way to the barracks. Who went that way to the chimneys? He sent me to the barracks. Vika. He sent to the chimneys. For 3 months, I saw that face. Till the Russians came. They executed 5 of the German officers. He got away.
Because he pretended to be Czech.
Imagine how I felt when I saw his face. Here in Australia, an article with a photo of him getting his award for services to the Hungarian community. I couldn't believe it. So I sold my house. I moved in here. And I watched and I waited.
I found a feather in his throat. Was it a pillow?
A cushion. I strapped his good arm down first. It's surprising how long it took. You would think I would know how long a person takes to suffocate.
And his award?
What will you do with me?
Nothing. Are you warm enough now?
That young man. Have his car searched.
No. Is he breathing?
Dan, I'm so sorry.
You tried CPR. Try and revive him. Here,
no.
Let me.
Dan, no. He has a DNR. Do not resuscitate. You know that. Jack has a DNR. Sorry.
Selfish bastard. You might have tidied up a bit before he left.
Who will it all go to?
Me, apparently. I'll have it sent to work until I can sort through it.
I can stay if you want.
The doctor still has to see him.
Okay. Well, call me if there's anything I can do.
Hello.
Simon Venrick?
It's Venrick. Yeah.
Parsil Health Tech Support. I got your email about some timesheets there at Turbot Street. The asterisk on October 3rd.
The 3rd, yeah.
Yeah, you guys had an outage late that night. Well, in the early AM of the 4th. Your server dumped out for some reason.
A server outage? That's a first.
Dr. Harrodbone threw all the times, though, so it was okay.
All the times.
He's a helpful guy.
Including his own?
Uh-huh.
Him anyway. Not like Jack. We all like Jack. I don't know why Dr. Scarrett is insisting on an autopsy.
He's just being thorough.
We'll miss him. I'm glad your girlfriend got to meet him.
Pardon?
The other night, the woman, the cop, she said she was your girlfriend when she came to see Jack. Pretty.
finger bone was cut with a serrated blade. I've seen the kid on his boat.
I want to organise a search warrant.
Harrow visited the surgeon's widow. He left with a file. I'm thinking about all the things that he did. When those bones first came up from the river.
Maybe he was just wrong.
When is he ever that wrong?
Do you really believe he'd kill someone?
I really need to find out.
Hands, Harrow! Stay right there, please! You have the right to remain silent.
I imagine you have a few questions.